doing waterproofing. Let's talk about it.
Good morning. When we said we were going to build our house, we meant it. This is our first day on the site where we will actually be doing some work, and we will be doing the waterproofing for the foundation. But first I wanted to show you my construction truck. It's a nice 2010 Honda Civic. Check that out. Check this out. It's kind of a funny story because when I lived in Chicago, I moved away, I went to college in Colorado. I had a Toyota 4Runner in the city. I always wanted to use it in the mountain, and I never did. It was always a city car. And now that I have a city car, a Honda Civic, I use it in the mountain. So next year we will be getting a truck though. We cannot live here without a truck.
It's waterproofing day, so safety first. I'm wearing glasses and I will be wearing a mouth cover. There's debris everywhere, there are nails coming out of the walls, and I will be lifting a lot of dust. So the first step is going to be clean up all the surfaces. So here we go. So as you can see, we have three different rooms. So the first one we have here, it's all rigid. This one is for all the big stuff, the drugs, the nails and whatnot. Then we have the second one. It has softer bristles on the end and then rigid in the center. This is more to still pushing small rocks out and catching some of the dust. And then we have the small one. This one is for all the corners. And pretty much for detail work, I do sweep. After these two, I do sweep with this one because it gets more of the dust out.
We were super busy yesterday and we didn't get a chance to do any recordings or anything, but I want to briefly show you what we did all day, pretty much from dusk till dawn. So we placed a blue poly wall, blue barrier along the footing transitions to protect the cold joint, footing to stem wall. We also added the Bituthene for the footings. And so today we are working on hopefully taking care of the Bituthene as much as possible. So here's a slight walkthrough of what we're doing. So Bituthene has a property where it needs to be installed in warm weather. So we gotta take advantage of these warm days that we have. And now that I mentioned Bituthene and polywall, let me show you how we're going to do this. Now that the surfaces are clean, the next process will be to apply polywall's blue barrier. But before I get into that, let me mention that we were going to use a full polywall system. We were going to use the pump stretch liquid waterproofing from polywall for the entire house. Except we decided against it because first, it requires like a nice spray gun that is difficult to find for rent, and it is very expensive to purchase. So the alternate solution we came up with, and they also allow it, is to roll it. So we were going to roll it, except until we got to the purchasing button. it turns out that buying for the entire house, it would have been like $17,000. So that was a little bit too crazy for us. So we decided to go for Bituthene. Each roll of Bituthene we purchased for $240. Funny story though, here in Colorado, each Bituthene was like $400 per roll, but we ended up purchasing it from North Carolina and shipped it over here. And even with the shipping and handling, it ended up being cheaper than buying it here locally for $400. So that's why you will see us using two methods, two systems, Bituthene and polywall. And with that out of the way, the polywall blue barrier is a protection between the cold joints of the stem wall and the footing. And it is to go along all the edges and along all holes bigger than 1 inch. And with that out of the way, I should also mention that we were able to win this nice cold gun from Advantech Zip Systems. So thank you for that. It's like $60 worth. We will be using a lot of Advantech once we get onto framing.
The next step in the Bituthene system is to apply the surface conditioner. Now, do not confuse this with the primer. The primer, you only need it if you have green concrete, meaning concrete that is less than 7 days old. So the conditioner goes in all the surfaces that will have Bituthene. After you apply it with a roller, just like paint, it takes about 1 hour to dry, but if you're in cold weather, it may take longer. You may notice here we have a different color where it has been applied and where it has not. Now, in cold weather, you need to be careful. It must be above 25 Fahrenheit or minus 4 Celsius so you can apply it. Before applying Bituthene on the walls and the footings, we need to do some detailed work. So we have a 12-inch strip that goes at the border of the footing, and then we have to detail the corners. And if you have any penetrations into the concrete. Now, this takes a lot of work and a lot of details, so I'm going to create another video to give you all the information.
Another recommended application of a blue barrier is to fill holes bigger than 2 inches. That's really up to you. It's your judgment, because they are not like clearly defined, like this 2 inch and whatnot. So whatever you see might seem big enough, you fill. Additionally, you are also to put a blue barrier around your penetrations, I guess. In this case, it will be the sleeves, because they have PVC inside, and so it is to protect against water from going in as much as possible, because water with cold, it could seep in and freeze and thaw, and then eventually break something. So that's ultimately what we're trying to protect against.
With the footings done, it's now time to place Bituthene on the walls. Here are two important things. On the wall, it must be in the vertical position, never ever put it horizontal, and the vertical strips cannot be more than 8 feet long. Now, this is a two-person job. One person is going to hold the Bituthene while the other one removes the paper in the back and sticks it to the wall.
Once all the bitutene is in place, the final step is to put mastic, bitutene mastic, at the bottom, at the seams between the concrete and the bitutene, overlapping like 1 inch into the concrete, 1 inch onto the bitutene, so that gives you effectively 2 inches worth of mastic. And so you do this at the bottom, you do this at the top. I've already done it at the top, so I'm going to show you very briefly how to do it at the bottom. What I can tell you for sure is this gun is extraordinarily hard. I wonder if it's the weather, if it's the cold weather, or I don't know what, but it is very difficult. You need to use both your hands for it. So give it a nice healthy dose of mastic, and spread it over, and that's basically all there is to it. You're not supposed to do this when it's raining and there's water and stuff, but as you can see there's snow, and ultimately there's nothing we could do about the weather, so we got done as much as we could, but that's where we are.
About 11 days of doing bituthene, cutting 20 rolls and installing about 1,300 feet of bituthene, we are so happy to call this done.
Yeah, this actually, I was expecting it would take like 3 days, but yeah, no. So get ready. And actually what I would say is, the reason it took so long is because we chose to do the footings. If you choose not to do the footings, you can probably cut the time in half or even more. So now we wanted to share some tips to help you if you're going to do this, at least with bituthene. So the first tip I can share with you is, in the previous scene you saw like me using the cold gun. That was a total workout, and I mean, I highly don't recommend it. What I do recommend is using this bucket. We actually ended up purchasing it from Home Depot, and it ended up working significantly better for top and bottom.
Another tip I can give you is the backing paper of the bituthene. It is extremely bulky. Try to do this. This is 8 feet of bituthene, and the moment you let go, it expands again.
Yeah, the first day our car was totally full.
Yeah, this is also 8 feet of bituthene. It's the exact same thing. So if you don't fold it, you're going to end up with 8 pieces like that. Whereas if you fold it, you can fit 12 of those in a single bag.
Another advice we can give you is try to cut the biggest pieces of bituthene and put them at the bottom, so that if you have to do really tall walls, you don't have to dance with them. And so the smaller they are at the top, the better. And then, yep.
I can talk about the conditioner. So the instructions say to apply it and wait at least 1 hour. What we found out is that if you wait 24 hours, it's much better. You're going to feel the surface super tacky.
Yeah, and then I guess that's about it. So please consider liking and subscribing, and we'll see you in the next episode.
Bye.
Bye.